my recording that way, it is okay. So we have solved this problem earlier also. So we have these supply points. So rather than naming them supply points, let us put them as the factory outlets that we have already discussed. So we have factories here. We have factories. Factories are you have warehouses A, B, C, and we have D. Okay, and then we have the okay, so we have A, factory A, factory B, factory C. Cost of transportation is 8, 6, this is 3, this is 9, this is 11, 8, this is 6, 5, 7, this one is 3, 10, 9. Can somebody tell me the supply? Supply was, I think, 18, 20, 18, if I remember it properly. Or well, let me go and check. 18, 20, 18, 15, 16, 12, 3, 13. Isn't it? Do you people write what I write here, or you are just listening and going home? Going back to sleep. Writing, good. If you are writing, then it will be good, because we will be continuing some problems like this only. So what is this value? This is 15, 15, 16, 12, 13. Okay. Can you tell me the allocations, last allocations that we have made?
Using which method, sir?
Anyone, I think, let us take this allocations only. Vogel's approximation, VAMP method, allocations.
At 9, we had an allocation.
Here.
Yeah.
Here we have 5.
And 13 at D, yeah.
13.
Yes, 1, 3.
1, 3. Okay. Then at 11.
At 11, 8. And at 5, 12.
8, 12.
Yes.
Then at 3, 15.
15 at 3 and 3 at 8.
Okay. Solution. Okay. Initial solution. What is the value of transportation? T was equal to
331
rupees. Okay. So now we are interested in solving it for the Modi method, that is not related anyhow to Narendra Modi. It is modified distribution method. MO means modified. Modified. And DI means distribution. Distribution. So modified distribution, which is called as Modi method. We are going to use this Modi method for the optimization. Now, what is optimization? Optimization means that you have a solution. You had a problem. You had a problem with the schedule of the transportation. So now you have got a schedule. What is the schedule? Schedule is that from factory A, 5 units will be transported to warehouse B. From factory A, 13 units will be transported to warehouse D. From factory B, 8 units will be transported to warehouse B. From factory B, 12 units. Is it correct? Similarly, you have for factory C. For factory C, we are going to transport 15 units from factory C to warehouse A, and 3 units from factory C to warehouse B. So we have a schedule, that is from A to D, then B to B, and B to C, C to A, and C to B. Correct? So this is our schedule. Okay? Any doubts in this? Students, this is very important. Any doubts up to this point, let me know.
Using this method, we need to find for every problem, sir.
Yes, when you are interested in finding the optimum value, you have to find the solution using modified distribution method.
Okay.
Whenever you have a transportation problem, unless and until it is mentioned that find only basic feasible solution or initial solution, if they are asking, as I said, if they are asking for like 4 marks or 2 marks or 3 marks, they may give you only for this, up to this point. They will not ask you for the modified distribution method. But as soon as you go into like you want to have it for the 10 marks, then they'll go with the VAM method. They'll have you to solve using VAM method. That is modified distribution method that will give you the optimal value. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what your Modi method says that CIJ.
Sir?
That is cost of transportation. Yes.
A to B, A to D. Yeah. How you taken, sir?
Okay. See, I have taken A to B because I have an allocation. Wherever there are allocations, what mean? This means that this many point to this outlet point. Okay. So that is why I have written from A to B. Number of units is 5. Wherever there is allocation, if you remember in the first class, I said that all these are called cells. Isn't it? Do you remember this?
Yes, sir.
In cells, we have two categories. One is called occupied. The other one is called unoccupied. Okay. Remember this?
Yes, sir.
Occupied means allocation. Unoccupied means no allocation. Correct? Allocation means whatever unit is written here will be transported from this particular supply point to this particular demand point. That's what I have written from A, factory A, to warehouse B, I am going to supply 5 units. Correct?
Aye, sir.
Okay. So let me just rub this. So now for modified distribution method, we say that all these Cj for occupied cell, we say all Cj, Cij is equal to Ui plus Vj. What is the Cij? Cij is your cost of transportation. Cij is cost of transportation, from ith row to jth column. Okay, this means C11 is cost of transportation, from factory 1, or in this case factory A, to warehouse A, small a, sorry, correct? So what is C11? C11 is equal to 8. This 8 is cost of transportation from first row, C11, first row to first column. So from factory A to warehouse A, the cost of transportation is this. This value is 8. Okay. For occupied cell, I am writing, I am assuming that there is an occupancy here. Okay. If there is an occupancy, or let us take C12. So from factory A to warehouse small b. Okay. Value is 9. Okay. Is there any doubt?
Sir, like this, we have to find for only the occupied cells or the total?
That I'll tell you. Don't worry about it. Be sure about here that for any occupied cell, wherever the occupied cell may be, what values you have to find, I'll tell you later. Okay. But for now, what you need to understand is for any occupied cell, whether it is for this particular problem, whether it is 1, 2, 1, 4, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, or 3, 2, isn't it? See, 1, 2, 1, 4, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2. All these are occupied cell. Correct?
Yes.
Any doubts in this?
No, sir.
If this is here, then we say that for these cells, the cost of transportation is always equal to Ui plus Vj. Now, what is Ui and Vj? Ui and Vj, for them, I'll just try to share a new value. Let me see, where is that book? Okay, so if we can go to some here. Okay, see, the interpretation of U's and I's, the value Ui, I think I'll share this book with you people, but let me see whether you are able to visualize this or not. Are you able to see it? Are you able to see the book?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Okay, great. So the value Ui, the value Ui value measures the Sorry, students, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, I got disconnected. My think the this internet is gone. So just wait for a second. I'll connect it back. Sorry for the disturbance. Okay, I'm not the host here, so I'll have to.
It's okay, sir.
So up to what point you have listened?
UI value.
Okay. So okay. So as I was saying, so this Cij value basically is comprising of U value or the value at the supply point and the value at the demand point. So as I was saying, and even I shared this book with you people, that at the supply center I, whatever the additional unit of supply we are making or any shadow price we are making, that shadow price could have given us the that shadow price which could have given us some value at the center is given by UI. And similarly, it may also be termed as location rent. So when we are transporting some value there, what that transportation will have some rent so associated with it. So that rents are the values that are associated with that particular supply unit only. Okay. Similarly, there will be certain values that are associated with the demand centers only. So those demand center values are called market prices. For example, you can buy a vegetable here at Ibrahim Patnam. Say, for example, if you are going to buy potatoes here, are you are getting it at a value of say 20 rupees per kg. But whereas if you try and buy a potato 1 kg at BN Reddy, the cost is say 30 rupees. So that 30 rupees is because the market price there, people are willing to pay 30 rupees to buy potato. Whereas if you go to Ibrahim Patnam, people are not willing to buy at a price of 30 rupees. They will buy only at a price of 20 rupees. So market price is also dependent upon the demand centers. Okay, where the demand is more, like BN Reddy, demand is more. So the market price is higher. If we at Ibrahim Patnam, people are more interested in buying those vegetables which are green leaves or something. So the cost of or the demand is less. That is why the market price is also less. Got my point? Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this point? So for this, we can say that the cost of transportation, Cij, is dependent upon some value from the supply point and some value from the demand point. Is it clear? Any doubts up to this point?
Sir, once again.
Okay, once again I'll say, Cij is the cost of transportation from ith row to the jth column. Okay, so C12 is the cost of transportation for this particular example. I am saying the cost of transportation from factory A to warehouse B. Okay, now this cell comprises of a cost of transportation from factory A to warehouse B. So factory A will have certain rents associated with it that will be included in the cost of transportation. Okay, so that cost of transportation, like for example, for factory A, they need to pay some toll tax or something. So that will be included in the cost of transportation, isn't it? Whereas for factory B, it may be with the nearness, or there may be some lower, cheaper value, petrol available or something, like maintenance is not required, the roads are better or something. So there will be some cost associated with factory B. Okay, so that cost can be divided into two parts. One is the cost associated with the factories, the cost associated with the demand centers. Okay, so whatever the cost is associated here, that cost can be bifurcated into two parts. One associated with the factories, one associated with the demand centers. Is it clear now?
Yes,
is it clear, students?
So, is sir, they are overhead expenses, sir, like additional.
Not overhead expenses all the time, but sometimes it may be overhead expenses, sometimes it may be. Rather than understanding it as an overhead expense, understand that the cost can be divided into two parts. One associated with the factories, the other associated with the design demand centers. Okay.
Okay.
So bifurcation is done. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now this is for the occupied cell. But for unoccupied cell, now we are not interested in calculating the cost, but we are interested in calculating the deficiency. So we will calculate Dij, which is equal to Cij minus Ui plus Vj. Okay. So for unoccupied cell, so for example D11, because D11 in this particular example is unoccupied cell, isn't it? This is unoccupied cell, correct? Any doubt, students? This is unoccupied cell, na?
Yes. Students?
Okay. So this is unoccupied cell. So for unoccupied cell D11, it is equal to C11 minus Ui plus, sorry, U1 plus V1. Okay. So if I want to calculate D11, I need a value of C11 minus, I need the value associated with the factory Ui. So I'll write here one column I'll add. We'll name this as Ui, and similarly, actually, I need to make one more. Okay, let me just. And here I'll make VJ. Okay. Any doubts up to this point? So I need the value associated with U1 and value associated with V1. Now, how to calculate these values? Question comes, how to calculate these values? For this, what we will do is we will search the row or the column with maximum allocation. Which row or column is having maximum allocation? So what I'll see here is row A is having two allocations, one at 2 and other at 4, correct? Any doubts? So this row is having two allocation. This row is also having two allocation. This row is also having two allocation. Okay. Sorry, I forgot one thing to tell. Let me just write it. Let us say that we have M rows. So number of rows here is 1, 2, and 3. Correct? And N columns. So N columns are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. So number of allocations will always be equal to M plus N minus 1. So M plus N is 3 plus 4 minus 1 is equal to 6. Correct? Is it correct, students? Any doubts here? a small mistake. This I should have told earlier only when we were discussing all these methods. Every time when you are making allocations, allocations will always be equal to m plus n, that is number of rows plus number of columns minus 1. Okay. So you can see here, there are two rows, two allocations, 4, 2 allocations, 6. Okay. If this is not equal, then there is some other case. We will discuss it later. Okay. Any doubts?
No, any doubts, sir.
Okay. So now for calculating these values, we need to find the row or column which is having maximum allocation. So row 1 is having 2 allocations, row B is having 2 allocations, row C is having 2 allocations. So there is a tie. 2, this you should not write. I'm just writing for your reference. Okay. So 2, 2, 2. Similarly, we'll see the columns. Column A have 1 allocation. Column B have 3 allocations. Column C have 1 allocation. Column D have 1 allocation. Correct? Which is having maximum allocation?
Column B.
Yes, column B or column 2 is having maximum allocation. So when we find the maximum allocation for that particular column, we will make that value either Vj or Ui as 0. So I'll make this as 0. If I make this as 0, then C12 is equal to U1 plus V2. Correct? I can write this. For this particular cell, C12 is equal to U1 plus V2. I can write this. Any problem at this point? Students, any problems? If not, we will write this as 9 is equal to U1 plus 0. So this implies that U1 is equal to 9. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can I write UI as 9 here?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, can I write as 11 here? Same method. C22 is equal to U2 plus V2. C22 is 11. U2 is U2 plus V2 is 0. Implies that U2 is equal to 11. Similarly, this will be equal to 8. That is C23 is equal to C32 is equal to U3 plus V2, implying that 8 is equal to U3, correct? Plus V2 equal to 0. So this will be 8, correct? Any doubts? Any doubts, students? If not, can I write C31 is equal to U3 plus V1? So that will be equal to 3 is equal to 8 plus V1. That will be equal to minus 5. Correct? Simple mathematics. Can I write it, students?
Yes, sir.
समझ आ रहा है कि is it clear or there are lot of doubts because the energy level has gone down.
Clear, sir. Okay.
Okay, don't worry, this is all good. Okay, just what we need to do is for all the allocated cell, we have to write these values. Similarly, we can find for C23 for, let me write it here, C23 is equal to U2 plus V3. Okay, C23 is 5. 5 is equal to 11 plus V3, implying that V3 is equal to minus 6. So we will get a value of minus 6 here. Similarly, C 14 is equal to U1 plus V4, implying that the cost is 3. So 3 is equal to 9 plus V4, implying that V4 is also equal to minus 6. Correct? So this is also minus 6. Similarly, once this is done, we have to calculate the deficiency value at all the points. So unallocated, so for all unallocated cell, I'll create a box here. For every unallocated cell, I'll create a box. Okay, for these unallocated values, I'll calculate this value. So C11, D11 is equals to C11 plus U1 plus V1. So that is equal to C11 is 8 minus U1 is, we know U1 is 9 minus, because, or let us write plus, of minus 5. Correct? So that will be equal to 9 minus 5 is 4, 4 minus 8 minus 4 is 4. Correct? Any problems? So this value becomes 4. For here, we will write D13 is equal to C13 minus of U1 plus V3. That is equal to C13 is 6 minus of U3, U1 is 9 minus V3 is 6. So 6 minus 6 is 0. Sorry, 6 plus 6 will become 12. 12 minus 3, 9 is 3. Okay. So this is 3. Correct? Similarly, D, D1, sorry, 2, 1 will be equal to C, 2, 1 minus U2, U2, U2 plus V1, that is equal to 6 minus of 11 minus 5. So that will be equal to 12, 11 minus 11 as 0. Correct?
Yes.
5 minus 11 minus 5 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So I'll write a 0 here. Correct? Similarly, D2, D24 is equal to C24 minus of U2 plus V4. C24 is 10 minus of 11 minus 6. Okay. So 11 minus 6 is 5. 10 minus 5 is 5. So I'll write 5 here. Correct? Similarly, D3 is equal to C33 minus of U3 plus V3. Correct? That will be equal to C33 is 7 minus of 8 minus of 6. 8 minus 6 is 2. 2 minus 7 minus 2 is 5. So here also it will be 5. Similarly, D34 is equal to C34 minus of U3 plus V4. That will be equal to 9 minus of 8 minus 6. So 8 minus 6 is 2. 9 minus 2 is 7. So 7. Okay. Any doubts up to this point? So what we see here is all the penalties, that is all dij values is greater than zero, optimal solution. Okay, if dij value is less than zero, then new solution to be found. How to find new solution, that I'll tell you later. Okay, but if dij is equal to zero, hai koi value dij equal to zero? Is there any value dij which is equal to zero? Students, is there any value which is equal to zero, dij value?
Yes, sir.
Which value is?
D21
is equal to zero. This time, if this means that if any value of dij is equal to zero, then exists an alternative solution. Now, I should not repeat again, but I'll repeat here. What are the various types of solutions? Solutions are optimal solution, which is unique. Okay. That is, you have only one solution. Correct? Which is the maximum value or the minimum value depending upon the problem. For transportation, it should be the minimum value. Correct?
Yes.
Is it correct or not? Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Similarly, there can be one more solution, which is called alternative solution, where the cost of transportation may not change, but there is one more chance where you can include the 0.2 and warehouse 1. Okay, there is a chance where you can use 0.2 or factory B to warehouse 1 without changing the cost of transportation. Is it correct? Is it understood?
Sir, I didn't get. Could you please tell again?
I'll tell you again that we already had a schedule, isn't it?
Okay.
We already had a schedule. That is, from A to B, we will send some quantity. From A to B, we will send some quantity. From B to B, we will send some quantity. From B to C, and so on. Okay, but now with these values, we can say that if we include some quantities from B, send it to A, then also we will end up with a schedule which will not change the cost of transportation. The cost of transportation will be same, but we will be changing the quantities that we are transferring from one point to the other. So schedule may change, but the total cost will remain same. That is the cost 331. Okay. Is it understood now?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how to get this alternative solution? We will discuss in next class, because see, only 5 minutes are remaining. If I start a new topic now, it will be difficult. So if you people have any doubt up to this point, please tell me now, because what I feel, if you are comfortable with calculating these values, this is very important. If you are comfortable with calculating this value, next time we can solve this pretty much fast. Okay. Okay, students. So please try and understand this now. That for any occupied cell, Cij is equal to Ui plus Vj. Now, how to decide which one to take? You can take arbitrarily any value as zero. See, I have taken this V2 as zero. Na? Here I have taken V2 as zero. Because I have used a method that whichever is having maximum allocation, I will use that as zero. This is my way of doing it easy. Okay. Otherwise, if you see the book will say that arbitrarily you can take any value as zero. That is, even I can take ui or u1 as zero, which is say 9. Na? I could have taken this as zero. Then I could have evaluated your v4, then v2. With the value of v2, I could have evaluated u2 and u3. With the value of u3, I could have evaluated v1. With the value of u2, I could have evaluated v3. Okay. Using the same formulas. Okay. Randomly, you can take any one as zero. But to make it easy, what I've done is I've taken the allocation where we have maximum allocation as zero. So if I take this as zero, I can instantly write C11 as U3, sorry, C31 as U3, C32 as U2, C12 as U1. Correct? Simple values. Okay. So if you are comfortable with these value calculation, then it will be very easy. So what we have done for modified distribution method in today's class is first we will see whether the allocations are appropriate or not. How to calculate allocations are appropriate or not? We have to see the number of allocations, whether it is equal to m plus n minus 1. So we see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we have 3 factories, A, B, C, and 4 warehouses, A, B, C, D. So 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 minus 1 is 6. So a number of allocations are good. If the number of allocations are not equal to m plus n minus 1, then it will be called a degenerated problem. We will discuss degenerated problem later. Let us not get confused with it now here. So if it is correct, then we have to see how many occupied cells are in a column or in a row. Okay. So maximum number of allocations we will find. So maximum number of allocations are in V2 or column 2. So for column 2, we have taken V2 as 0. Then we have calculated for each occupied cell, Cij is equal to ui plus vj. We have evaluated for all the values of ci and all the values of ui and vj. After calculating all the values for ui and vj, then for unoccupied cell, for unoccupied cell, we will calculate all dij values. Once we calculate all dij values, once we calculate all dij values, then we see the dij values. If all the dij values are positive, that means there is nothing that we can improve. Okay. If there's any value which is negative, then we can make an improvement. If all the values are positive, then we say that there is no chance of improvement and thus it is the optimal solution. If it is less than zero, then there is the solution is not optimal and we can find a new solution. If the values are exactly equal to zero, then there exists an alternative solution. Correct? Any doubts? Any doubts, students?
No, sir.
Okay. So in next class, we will see the alternative solution and a new solution kind of a problem. So we'll continue with this in the next class. Okay, students? Is it okay, students?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for joining. Aditya, have you taken the attendance?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please send it to me, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you for joining, everybody. Have a good day.